Tonight on Sydney Soapbox, we're asking, can you really afford to live in Sydney? Let us know your views on Facebook, Twitter or email.
In a moment, we'll hear what social affairs writer Jessica Irvine has to say, but now, here's the view from Glebe.
I think you have to earn above average wages, I think that's for sure, and it's a tough place, I'd say, if you're a pensioner or if you're a unemployed.
I'm finding it difficult to live in here at the moment, the expenses and everything.
Absolutely not. I live in a falling down share house with a bunch of students.
Not without a job.
You spend, but you earn too. And every now and then we have problems like bananas, for example. Well, don't eat bananas, eat something else.
Yes, I can, I'm lucky.
No, not at all. I've got to live at home because I'm at uni, it's too expensive.
It's just the rent, really. Like, that's the killer.
As usual, a variety of opinions. Yeah. Let's now talk to Jessica Irvine. Jessica, Sydney is, of course, a beautiful city and the reason many people choose to live here, but for how long can they afford it?
Yeah, it's funny. You ask people, is Sydney an expensive place to live? And it's kind of like asking, is an Armani suit expensive? Yes, it is compared to shopping in Target, but it's a beautiful suit and you want to wear it and people want to live here. The interesting thing we've had out today is a survey showing that for foreigners, it's a particularly expensive place to come and visit. There was a survey by the UBS Investment Bank, which showed that it's the seventh most expensive city in the world. And part of that is to do with the Aussie dollar, because the Aussie dollar's up, it's harder for foreigners to be able to afford to buy things here. But even within Australia, Sydney is an expensive place to live, particularly if you like bananas, although I understand bananas are more expensive in Perth at the moment, but that's a tangent. When you look at Sydney house prices, we're at about $515,000 for the median house, and nationally, that's only about $465,000, so that's a lot more expensive. Wages are high here, but not enough to compensate. We only get about $1,000 extra a year compared to the national average.
But what choice do people have, really, in a sense, Jessica, because you do have to go where the jobs are to some degree, and a lot of the jobs, most of them, are in the city. A lot of the regional centres are suffering under the GFC.
Yeah, we have this situation in Australia where we're all clustered in cities on the shore, and we work in CBDs in the middle of the city, so that really puts a premium on living in the city. And of course we've got beautiful waterside properties in Sydney, and they cost, you know, you'd think that they might cost a little bit more because it is a nice place to live. And so when you look internationally, we do rank very highly in terms of how unaffordable our properties are for the average income earner.
Well, thank goodness we like the city after all. Thank you, Jessica Irvine there.
Thanks.